Howdy. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna do some, I have a package here. Someone sent me some razors and I'll take it through this time. This one that I'm going to do, he sent me two razors. There's a Dobo and that one's pretty straightforward, but I have here a TI. This one, there's a little bit of an issue with this one, and this one has some geometry issues. So I'll take you through this razor on how I do it, and it's a little more interesting than just plain old sharpening a razor. So what I wanted to show you on this is, I don't know if you can see this here, you can hear it. There's definitely a wobble to this thing. And these TI razors, yeah. And it's really weird. It seems like it has a high spot in the center of the spine on both sides, which means to me, it's just the grind is off. I mean, I've seen this a lot on these TIs. I guess it's just common. Unfortunately, it affects the way the razor will work if it's not corrected, but I'm gonna show you how I correct them. So what I just did is I put some tape on the blade, and I'm gonna go straight to my diamond plate. So if homeware bothers you, you wanna fast forward here. All right, so this is my 400. And what I'm gonna do, I don't know if you can see the wear. I don't know if where your light is, but so far it's only hit in the center. So again, there's a high spot on the center of this thing. So I'm gonna do a little bit more on it to get that down. Right, there's some more, let me flip this. Right now it's all the way across. So that part's flat. Let's get this side. And again, the reason I'm taping the edge is because I don't want to be removing metal while I'm doing this on the edge. That's much thinner and a little more fragile. And most of this issue and the grind issue is a problem on the spine. It's about 3/4 of the way. I don't know if you can see it, but yep, that's all the way down to there and there. Okay. Let me take it over to the granite. You can come on over here. Yeah, that wobble's all gone. So it's time to pull the tape. Let me see how it does without it. Yep. That's totally flat. So let's go back over here. Now what I'm gonna do is blend the spine with the edge. I'm looking for here is to see the wear all the way across, and it is. A little bit on the heel. Yeah, that's all the way across. Okay, so we're done on that. What I'm doing next, this is my 1200 Atoma plate. And what I'm doing here is just smoothing out the 400. You can see the light reflect off of that. Very nice. Okay.
So we're done with that. The next step
is the 5000. I used to go to my 1000, my Chocera 1K at this point, but I figure that the 1200 is a 1K. So I'm just gonna go to my 5, skip that step, and this works out fine. Someone had commented on the last video that this 5K cuts pretty quick, and it does, and especially if you use slurry on it like I'm doing. When people send me these razors, like this, the gentleman who sent me this said he tried to hone it and he just couldn't quite get it there, as he said in the note. And usually the problem with that is people are just a little bit afraid to take it as far as it needs to go. And that's okay. I guess I used to do that. But someone asked me, said that it looks pretty easy what you do. And I said, well, I said it takes some work. I said, but you need to ruin a couple, two or three razors. I said, then you'll get your game together. So what we're doing here is smoothing out all of those diamond plate lines. Oh yeah. That cuts all along. But since I didn't kill the edge when we began, I honestly don't know if it's cutting from the edge that was there before or not. I'm sure it's what I put in there. After I put it on the diamond plate, it reprofiled that edge. But let's go to the 8K. This is the Norton 8K. And again, I'm using a worn Atoma 400 plate here to lap this. Now I'm going to take and kill it. There's no edge left on that. So I will bring it back, and that way I'll know for sure that I put that edge on there. And someone else asked me about these half strokes that I do. What you'll see is you'll see me do them this way, and then you'll see me turn it 90 degrees and do it this way. And what I'm doing is just, you know, your scratch marks go this way when you do it this way. When I go 90 degrees, now it goes, you know, 90 degrees of that, and it obliterates the previous scratch marks instead of just making them deeper and deeper. Now we're removing even those marks. And by the way, I was telling some people, the biggest problem I see with other people honing, and people will tell me that they're having issues honing, they're afraid to use pressure. I am leaning on this thing. I mean, this is an 8K stone. Look at all the metal that's come off. When I say leaning on, I'm not just pushing hard that way. What I'm doing is torquing that thing down. I'm torquing that edge into the stone. I don't know who came up with this weight of the blade nonsense, but you're not gonna be removing any metal with weight of the blade. I mean, weight of the blade is fine for your last, you know, 8-10 passes on your finishing stone, but everything before that, I lean on it. I'm leaning on it now. All right, let's see how we did. Woo! Beautiful. All right, let me finish it on this with water, and then I'm going to check the edge under the scope, and then I'll do the finish. Oh yeah. Come on with me, let's check this. Yeah. Okay, can you see that? That is some good steel right there. That's an 8K, man. All right, let's go back and finish her up. Okay, so what I'm going to use, here, take a look, pick up here. What I'm going to use is, this is the ILR. The gentleman who sent me the razor said what he's going to do is he wants to finish on the ILR. He has an ILR stone and an 8K. So by correcting the geometry, I'm going to make it real easy for him to just do an 8K and this stone. So if someone tells me that, what I want to do is send them the stone or send them a razor that was finished on the same stone that they're going to use. That way they'll kind of have a goal to shoot for. Under running water. Simple enough. Yeah, it gets sticky. Ooh. Yep. Okay.
You can show this here. What I'm going to do is just, I'll drop it.
This is my fire hose. I'll do 20 here. On a natural stone, I usually give it a little bit more stropping than the last video I did when I finished on the CBN. Kaniyama, I remembered this time. All right, let's
I'll get back on.
Now, I said I wasn't going to do this because it's a parlor trick. All right? Hanging hair test. Let's see if you can see this. One of these ends has the knob on it. Oh, maybe not. It feels like this one here. There. Pink. Pink. Flying off of there. Who's better than that edge now? Yeah, that's a great, nice, smooth edge. The gentleman was going to be real happy with this. Can you see? There is honeware on this thing, but I make it look like a mirror, though. A little more honeware on this side, but the edge, there's some unevenness to the edge. That has to do with the grind. It was just uneven there. Here. Okay, so I think that's going to be it. There's really not much to it, so I appreciate you tuning in, and I'll do the other razor, and I didn't think you wanted to see that. All right, guys, that's it. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you real soon. Yeah, give me that. All right, I want to introduce my new cameraman. This is Danny. His brother, who used to do the filming, is now living in Denmark, the one who used to play the violin, Nikki. And Danny has taken over, and someone had commented on the last video that they got into my channel because they saw Danny's Lego candy machine when he was 6 years old. That was 9 years ago. Danny's now 15, and he's 6'2". He's taller than I am, and I just wanted to say, hey, welcome, Danny. You've done a great job so far. Do you have anything to say?
My name is Danny, and thanks for watching.
All right, then.
Hello, my name is Danny, and I'm 6 years old, and I'll be showing you my Lego candy machine. First, you load it with the piece of candy, and then try to push the level. So much that your managers had to say. Son, I'm proud of you. Can you sit for a while? He shook his head and he said with a smile. What it really like that is to follow the display. See you later.
Get your money back. Take the key out. Take the door off easily. Take this out. When you're coming home, son, I don't know where. We'll get the camera. Reload. 25 cents, the gun comes out, display, and yeah. So, comment, please, and my name's Danny, and thank you very much for watching.
Well, I've long since retired, my son's moved away, I caught him up just the other day. I said, I'd like to see you if you don't mind. He said, I'd love to, Dad, if I could find a time. You see, my new job's a hassle, the kids have the flu. But it's sure nice talking to you, Dad. It's been sure nice talking to you. And as I hung up the phone, it occurred to me, he'd grown up just like me. My boy was just like me. The cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon. Little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, son, I don't know when. We'll get together then, Dad. Gonna have a good time then.